Our next speaker is Professor Zdenka Kraljičkova from the Masaryk University of Brno about the Czech family law, family protection. Professor, you are the next, and please take the floor.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, dear professors, good afternoon. First of all, thank you very much for having me here for both the project and this conference. I am very happy to be here, although I don't feel very well. Last time I was speaking online about family life and family law in general. I stress that we all know that there are big changes in Europe. The portrait of family has been changing, which is reflected in legal orders in different countries. Unfortunately, there are a lot of pathological phenomena in families, domestic violence in all the forms of family life. That is why I decided to present my paper on the law against domestic violence in Czechia. Let me start by briefly touching on some main turning points in our history and legal development. As you can see, I have listed the most important turning points here. I would like to remind that the Czech Republic is a part of former Czechoslovakia, and still we have so much in common with Slovakia and Poland. Our legal orders are still very similar, thanks to the Common Commission on Family Law that was established after the World War, and thanks to the human rights conventions signed after the collapse of communism. Besides that, there are new acts reflecting harmful behavior, such as domestic violence. There may be differences in details in these countries. However, in essence, the concept of protection of victims of domestic violence is and must be the same. It's generally known that life, and especially family life, must be protected. All the forms of families are protected by the Convention for the Protection of Human Rights and Fundamental Freedoms and by the Charter of Fundamental Rights and Freedoms. In principle, the state should not intervene into private life, into intimacy of families. The state should respect the autonomy of will of each person to live according to his or her wish, and create such a model of family life that would correspond to his or her choice of life, family life, and so on. However, if there is a weak party in the family, the state should protect his or her interests, needs, health, life. Anybody can be in a position of a weak party or vulnerable person. Anybody can be at risk socially. It can be a child, it can be a socially or economically dependent partner, cohabitee, a spouse, a parent, a grandparent, a sibling. It's sometimes very difficult to find out that there is a need for protection by a state from outside if there are no signals, no requests or cry for help. And it's very difficult to find adequate means that would help the situation, especially if there are minor children in families affected by domestic violence, if the offense is committed against or in the presence of children, the means must follow both the short term and the longer term aims. Sometimes it's not enough to ban the perpetrator of domestic violence from family home and punish him or her, but it's necessary to make an arrangement of personal care of children, visiting rights, divorce, a settlement of community property, and common lease or ownership of a flat or a house, maintenance duty, and so on. In general, the state must have space to intervene into family life. Regarding Czech legal protection against domestic violence, we can speak about evolution from only criminalization of offender to a comprehensive legal protection of victims of domestic violence, even in civil law. First, there was a new crime added into criminal code by the amendment in 2004 named torture of a person living in a joint occupied apartment or house. In 2006, the lawmaker tried to introduce, according to the Austrian model, a comprehensive legal protection against domestic violence by an act that should change the Act on the Police, Civil Procedure Code, Civil Code, and other public law acts, and create and establish intervention centers. The act was passed, however, only the Civil Code was not amended at all. regarding positive results of comprehensive amendments, I should mention adoption of a police ban, adoption of a special emergency barring orders by the civil courts, and creation of intervention centers, special support services. Their aim is to provide the victims of domestic violence with active social and legal help, and if necessary, with shelters. Later on, the Children Act was amended. It was stressed that social legal protection must be provided to the children at risk caused by domestic violence in families, especially between the parents. Finally, in the year 2012, a new civil code was passed. Family law was incorporated into its book too, and protects family based on marriage, mainly family based on marriage. Registered partnership for the couples of the same sex is regulated by the special act from the year 2006. However, regarding our topic, domestic violence, it must be said at the beginning that the civil code protects all the family members against domestic violence, no matter what kind of family life they live in. This protection by the civil code is in harmony with the Convention for the Protection of Human Rights and Fundamental Freedoms and with the Charter of Fundamental Rights and Freedoms. Later on, I would like to give you more details. Now, I would like to stress that the legal questions of domestic violence are relatively new, but it's impossible to think that domestic violence is only a problem of last tens of years. There is not any legal definition in the Czech Republic, but there are a lot of non-legal definitions, for instance, by the Czech associations, Bílý kruh bezpečí, according which domestic violence includes all kinds of physical, sexual, economic, and psychological violence with all kinds of intimate relationships. Domestic violence is hidden, intensity usually increases, which leads to the loss of the ability to stop incidents and to solve domestic violence effectively. Regarding current legal protection against domestic violence in the Czech Republic, there here you can see the list of current sources of law. Later on, I will give you more details. So you can see that domestic violence is mentioned in the Police Act and Act on Special Civil Court Proceedings, Criminal Code, Criminal Procedure Code, Civil Code, and Children Act. Firstly, I would like to give you some details about protection against domestic violence in the Police Act. If police finds out that the assault is real and its repeat is imminent, the perpetrator may be banished from the common dwelling for the period of 10 days. It can be done ex officio, so no application by a victim is needed. In these cases, the perpetrator is only entitled to take his or her own items for personal use. In the next 10 days, the perpetrator is not allowed to enter the common dwelling or contact a victim. The banishment by police is de facto act. And as a novelty from these days, it's provided that the policeman has a duty to check within three days if the perpetrator respects the ban. Regarding protection against domestic violence by civil courts, it's important to mention that there are special emergency barring orders regulated by the Act on Special Civil Proceedings. It's provided that if the acting of a participant, perpetrator, against whom the proposal is filed, puts life, health, freedom, or human dignity of the plaintiff, a victim of domestic violence, or somebody else at serious risk or immediate danger, the presiding judge with the interim measure shall impose the perpetrator of domestic violence, participant against the proposal is filed, especially the following, to leave the shared dwelling and the immediate vicinity, and not to stay in or enter the shared dwelling. Then not to enter the intermediate vicinity of the shared dwelling or the one of the plaintiff. Then to refrain from meeting, contacting the victim of domestic violence, and to refrain from undesirable following and bordering of the plaintiff, it's stalking. Duration of barring orders is 1 month. And in addition, preliminary measures may be prolonged on the motion of a victim of domestic violence up to the sufficient period. And after 6 months, the barring orders extinct. Czech criminal code defines a lot of crimes that are connected with the problems of violence and domestic violence. What do they have in common? It's always ex officio prosecution. It means no application by a victim of domestic violence is needed, and no consent by a victim of domestic violence with prosecution is necessary. In relation to preliminary rulings of barring orders, according to the Act of Special Civil Proceedings and banishment by the police, the criminal code sets the regulation of a crime of obstructing of authoritative decision. However, criminal code regulates two main crimes in this respect, which are torture of person living in a common dwelling and stalking. In addition, Czech criminal procedure code provides quite new prohibition of entering the dwelling. In short, it's a ban to enter the dwelling and its immediate vicinity, and it can be decided ex officio by the state prosecutor or a criminal judge. And in fact, it's preliminary measure. And regarding its duration, it may be ordered for a period of time of continuance of criminal prosecution. As it was already said at the beginning, new civil code provides some special private law provisions against domestic violence too. First of all, let me stress provisions where domestic violence is explicitly stated. Civil Code in its book 2, Family Law, in relation with family dwelling of married couple, provides that a further cohabitation of spouses in a building or an apartment in which the family household is located becomes unbearable for one of the spouses due to physical or mental violence committed against him or her, or another person living with the spouses in the family household, a court may, on the application of the affected spouse, limit or even exclude the right of the other spouse to reside in the building or apartment for a determined period. The same procedure may be applied to divorced spouses. The court shall limit or exclude a spouse's rights to reside in a building or apartment for a maximum period of 6 months. The court shall, on the application, decide again, if justified, by particular serious reasons. Finally, it's provided that any other person who lives with the spouses or divorced spouses in the family household also has the right to seek protection against domestic violence. And as I mentioned at the beginning, thanks to the Human Rights Conventions, the special provision located at the end of the Civil Code provides that rules against domestic violence regulated in the Book 2 Family Law apply for all. It means that anybody, for instance, registered couples of the same sex or vulnerable seniors can apply for the protection. However, there are other provisions. Those can be used to protect victims of domestic violence, married ones only. Let's mention the ban to sell things that make up the usual household equipment and the ban to sell a family household. I don't have time to come to details, but I would like to mention another protection. In short, beside what I mentioned, domestic violence is mentioned in the Book 2 Family Law in relation to with maintenance duty between ex-spouses. And finally, domestic violence is mentioned in the Book 3, absolute rights in relation to succession law. Sorry, I don't have time to read all the provisions. I would like to mention the Children Act in this context. Children Act was amended as well. And first of all, the definition of a child at risk was extended. Thanks to the amendment, a child endangered by violence between the parents or other persons is considered to be a child at risk to whom the protection should be provided. Authorities of the child protection have an obligation to bring a claim before a court on behalf of the child and to represent the child during hearing regarding preliminary measures and regarding child custody, maintenance, visiting rights, limitations, or deprivations of parental responsibility, and an obligation to assist contacts with a child. However, there are many problems in practice. Social workers ask a lot of questions which are very difficult to answer. For instance, can a victim of domestic violence be a good partner or caregiver? Sometimes not. That is why the children of victims or witnesses of domestic violence are given to custody to their grandparents or sometimes even to substitute family care. Here, You can see some details regarding statistics. First of all, I would like to mention that there are almost 11 million of inhabitants in the Czech Republic, and the chart shows the number of police bans between the years 2007 and 2020. Besides that, Association of Intervention Centers provided numbers of persons at risk in 2020 as follows. There were 621 children, 1,163 women, and 187 men. They were reported as people as a risk. According to the findings, domestic violence was presented in all forms of families, and minor children were very often presented. Let me make some conclusions. Domestic violence is a worldwide problem which covers all spheres of people's life. That is why we cannot say no to any forms of pathological behavior. The question is, how should legal order look like, and how much should the state intervene into families affected by domestic violence? Too little or too much? As I said at the beginning, in general, the state must have space to intervene into family life, and the state must struggle for proportionality. In my opinion, the legal protection against domestic violence in the Czech Republic is quite comprehensive. Besides the very important emergency barring orders by the police or by the courts, there are a lot of other measures that could protect the victims of domestic violence well if used appropriately and at the right time in practice. However, prevention shouldn't be forgotten. And finally, regarding the new convention on preventing and combating violence against women and domestic violence from Istanbul, I would just say that it was signed by the Czech Republic in the year 2016. However, the convention was not ratified yet. Thank you very much for your attention. Thank you.